Will he try the Belgian door on the same side of the street or will he not? He's going to gamble. Could all three be on the same side? If he's gambled wrong, he goes back to the electronics factory where he works in Bath. Has he gambled right to the Swiss door? To the Portuguese door? Oh, surely he hasn't made a mistake. He's got three, yes, he has three in the time. 50 seconds. 50 seconds, you're in for a win here, Jeff. Come, you've got to get under the time of 1:02. Coming up to 1 minute. Quickly, cheer him on. 1:05, throw them in. You've come for points, Jeff Palmer. One, two, three, away!
Was Jeff Palmer a hero, yay or nay or yay?
Yeah. For Great Britain, a time 1:15.
1:15 for West Dorset. Guido leaves my side to speak with the advisor, André Lange. They come, a small problem.
Yeah, we must correct the time of Belgium. The right time was for Belgium 1:18 and not 1:02.
Oh, that's good news. They're outside the British time. Framery 1:18.
Alors, je répète en français. En français pour la Belgique. Le temps pour la Belgique a été corrigé à 1:18 parce que le temps de 1:02, c'était pas juste.
Now the Portuguese are on the starting line.
Attention. Attention. 3, 2, 1.
This is Antonio. He's a 21-year-old student in Villarreal.
Oh, he's very quick, isn't he?
Not only very quick, but very excitable too.
Oh, it's a good one. What a good guess.
Villarreal, of course, up in the mountains of Portugal, celebrated for the quality of their wine, the rosé on the port. The press gang on its way. Well, Sir Francis Drake used many press gang sailors in his fleet in his voyage, his epic voyage around the world in 1577. But Drake himself, something of a dandy on the Golden Hind, he dined off silver dishes, and would you believe, a little orchestra played for him at mealtimes. A real dandy. And wasn't Queen Elizabeth I a mercenary? Would you believe that she took a cut of all the plunder that Raleigh and Drake and the rest of them brought from around the world? The time, attention to the time. We're outside the West Dorset time, so you can give them a cheer. They've got to be completely inside for a time to be taken.
So, for Portugal, a time 1:34.
1:34 for the Portuguese of Villarreal, Matheus. The Italians of Brizzano, on the very heel of Italy, travelled well over 1,300 miles. We are set. Well, I've seen this guy. He's electrified. Watch this Italian fly.
Okay, attenzione l'Italia. 3, 2, 1.
He really wants to dip, this chap. If you cheer him a little, he'll bolt straight over the set. He gets a pillow at the back of the head. One sailor for the gang. Assistance from the back. Somebody riding a tugboat. Two. Let me have a look at Gennaro's time. 35 seconds for two. He's coming straight for us. Which would you go for? Portugal, he's gone. Wrong. Swiss. Right. Will he beat the British time of 1:15? He's had already 55 seconds. But we need a dummy to slip. Is he the sailor to calm himself? But it's not going to happen. What dreadful noise of water in mine ears, what sights of ugly death within mine eyes. Oh, before I saw a thousand fearful wrecks, a thousand men that fishes gnawed upon, I think 'tis bad news for West Dorset.
So we have Italy at time 1:15.
Oh, equal with West Dorset.
Yeah, equal. So we have at first place Switzerland 6 points.
That's why 6.
Then we have Great Britain 5 points.
West Dorset 5 points.
Execuo with Italy 5 points.
Vitano 5.
Then Belgium 3 points.
Primary 3 points.
France 2 points.
DF 2.
And Portugal 1 point.
Villarreal only 1 point. In the lead, the Swiss of Versoix with 37. Second, Villarreal 32. Third, Ulzin with 27. Fourth, West Dorset 26. Equal fifth, the F Lizano, 22 points apiece. And last, Flamery with 11. And for the last majestic Fil Rouge, it's over to you, Brian.
Sorry. Okay, well, the captain still doesn't seem to know what's going on around, but what is going on is an awful lot of tension. It's all on this run. Gennaro, start us off.
We are not ready yet.
We're not ready. They're not standing on their marks.
Attention. 3-2-1.
Over they go. Now, there are three, four teams who have got good time. There's Portugal, Great Britain, and Yugoslavia are all up there with a chance. Who's the first to hit the bedrock? Italian girl's coming out now. Got her leg stuck, got her skirt stuck. And who's this? Somebody in the bag already. This is Portugal. Portugal are doing it. Portugal are going to be first back by a long way. It's France. It's not Portugal. It's France. France and Great Britain. Great Britain are second. Yugoslavia in third, I think. But it's the kiss that counts, not the arrival. There's a great Swiss kiss coming. The French first kiss. The Swiss kiss, I think, and the Great Britain kiss, I think, third, because they fell on the floor. Oh, and the Portuguese have just fallen in. All around me is chaos.
So I can give you the times of this last marathon. We are for France, 42 seconds.
Dieppe, 42 seconds. That's the fast one.
For Switzerland, 51.
Switzerland, Versoix, 51.
For Yugoslavia, 51.
Ulzin, 51.
Great Britain, 52.
52 for Great Britain.
Portugal, 58.
Villarreal, Matthias, 58.
Belgium 104.
Belgium 104.
And we won't accept the time for Italy because the legs were completely out.
Right.
For Italy, maximum time.
Maximum for them.
We have for France 7 points.
France, 7 points for Dieppe.
For Great Britain, 6 points.
6 for West Dorset.
For Switzerland, 5 points.
Versoix, 5 points.
For Italy, 5 points.
Lizano, 5 points.
For Portugal, 5 points.
Portugal, Villarreal, Matthias, 5 points.
For Yugoslavia, also 5 points.
And 5 for Ulzin.
And for Belgium, only 1 point.
Only 1 point.
Yes.
So now that's how it looks at the moment. We've got Versoix at the top with 42, but there's a lot in this last game. Stuart, take it away.
Well, thank you very much indeed, Brian. We come to the last game. It all concerns the great big sailors with girls on their knees. On the whistle, up they go. They carry the girl across the quay to the house labelled in their own insignia. And from the other side of the quayside, another four come hurtling this way. Everything is let loose. Well, who's going to win? They cross over. Swiss with 42, the Portuguese with 37, Britain with 32. Will it be the Swiss with their 42 points qualifying Versoix for the final in Urbino? Where's the Swiss? There, the Swiss going in. The Swiss in the lead at the moment, qualifying for the final. The Swiss have Tesserete with 45 points. But if the Swiss win, with a bigger total than that, they qualify. And what about Portugal? Madeira are qualifying for them with 40 points. Yugoslavia coming back. The Yugoslavs
Well, they can't win it, so they won't qualify for the final, but what an exciting finale. Get your hands together, please. The Yugoslavs. The Italians. West Dorset coming in. We can't win it, but we're coming for a great finale. Wonderful. Yugoslavia win it. The game finishes when the hat and the sack and the sack is up. Come on, West Dorset. Well, West Dorset well pleased with the night's work. So Britain have finished, Yugoslavia finished, Switzerland, France, Italy, Portugal need to finish. Disappointing finish here for Villarreal Matheus. You've got to be strong. Give him a hand. That's it. Hoist him over. Belgium have gone. Applause, please, for all the contestants. Come on, come on, come on.
I give directly the point, directly the points. For Yugoslavia, 7 points.
For Olsen, 7 points.
For Great Britain, 6 points.
6 points for West Dorset.
France, 5 points.
Yep, 5.
Switzerland, 4 points.
Vincent, 4.
Italy, 3 points.
Vizal, 3.
Belgium, 2 points.
Spanish, 2.
And Portugal, 1 point. And
Villarreal, disappointingly, only 1 point. So the result of this glorious night in West Dorset, reading from the bottom. Last were Famery with 14 points, Lozano 6 with 30, Dieppe with 34, Villarreal 38, West Dorset with 38, Utsin with 39, but the winners are Versoix with 46. So applause please for Versoix, the Swiss team who came here. Thank you. Congratulations, applause, applause for the team of Versoix. And for everybody, and so we say...